girls. I'm Angela from Anyuan, Pingxiang. Nice to meet you. Today we are going to learn Unit 1, What's the Matter? Section A, Grammar Focus, 2-4C. We are going to revise what we've learned these days. In Unit 1, Section A, we've learned some phrases. So, first, let's put these phrases into English. Let's do it together, okay? Now, 躺下, lie down. If you have a sore back, you should lie down. Lie, 平躺. Do you remember that sentence? A woman saw an old man lying on the side of the road. Lying 是 lie 的现在分词 ,lying, 是一种特殊变化，大家要记一下。副要 ,right,put medicine on, 看牙医 ,see a dentist, 量体温 ,take one's temperature.If you have a fever, first, you should take your temperature. 休息 Take a break. If you are tired, you should take a break. 下车 Get off. 它的反义词组是Get on. 等待 Wait for. Now, do you remember that sentence? The driver expected most of the passengers or all the passengers to get off and wait for the next bus. 好，这两个词组大家还记得吧？被运用于我们的那个句子当中。及时 ,in time. 好，及时这个词组让我们联想到哪个词组呢 ?on time. On time 呢更强调按时。For example, we should finish our homework on time. 认真思考。Right. Think twice. Now, do you remember that sentence?The driver stopped the bus without thinking twice. 同意做某事 Agree to do something. 多亏由于 Yes, thanks to. And the last one. 使某人惊讶的是 To one'sSurprise. Do we remember how we used the phrases in the passage? Yeah. To the driver's surprise, all the passengers agreed to go with him. And thanks to the driver and all the passengers, the man was saved. 好。老师希望呢，大家在实际这些词组的时候，要把它与句子放在一起进行理解实际。这是我们学习英语的一个很好的一个方法。Now, in the last lesson, we learned how to retell a story. While we are reading the story, we should capture the useful information like when.When did the story happen? Who were in the story? Where did the story happen? What happened to them? And some other information. Now, let's look at the beginning of the passage. Please retell the beginning of the story.Using the information here. Okay, you can have a try. Now, Let's check the answer. At 9 o'clock a.m. yesterday, bus number 26 was going along Zhonghua Road when the driver saw an old man lying on the side of the road. A woman next to him was shouting for help. Now, let me get the task more difficult. Now, first, let's read the passage again.
Section A, Activity 3A. Read the passage. Do you think it comes from a newspaper or a book? How do you know? Bus driver and passengers save an old man. At 9 a.m. yesterday, bus number 26 was going along Zhonghua Road when the driver saw an old man lying on the side of the road. A woman next to him was shouting for help. The bus driver, 24-year-old Wang Ping, stopped the bus without thinking twice. He got off and asked the woman what happened. She said that the man had a heart problem and should go to the hospital. Mr. Wang knew he had to act quickly. He told the passengers that he must take the man to the hospital. He expected most or all of the passengers to get off and wait for the next bus. But to his surprise, they all agreed to go with him. Some passengers helped Mr. Wang to move the man onto the bus. Thanks to Mr. Wang and the passengers, the doctor saved the man in time. It's sad that many people don't want to help others because they don't want any trouble, says one passenger. But the driver didn't think about himself. He only thought about saving a life.
Now, boys and girls, please close your books and look at the screen. Please try your best to retell the story. Now, let me check your answer. The bus driver, 24-year-old Wang Ping, stopped the bus without thinking twice. He got off and asked the woman what happened. She said that the man had a heart problem and should go to the hospital. Mr. Wang knew he had to act quickly. He told the passengers that he must take the man to the hospital. He expected most or all of the passengers to get off and wait for the next bus. But to his surprise, they all agreed to go with him. Some passengers helped Mr. Wang to move the man onto the bus. Thanks to Mr. Wang and the passengers, the doctors saved the man in time. It's sad that many people don't want to help others because they don't want any trouble, said one passenger. But the driver didn't think about himself. He only thought about saving a life. Okay, that's all for the revision of the passage and the useful expressions. Let's come to the grammar focus. Read the sentences in the grammar focus together. Okay? What's the matter? I have a stomachache. You shouldn't eat so much next time. What's the matter with Ben? He hurt himself. He has a sore back. He should lie down and rest. Do you have a fever? Yes, I do. No, I don't. Or I don't know. Does he have a toothache? Yes, he does. He should see a dentist and get an x-ray. What should she do? She should take her temperature. Should I put some medicine on it? Yes, you should. No, you shouldn't. Now, let's get the key points in the grammar focus. Now, first, how do we ask about the matter? Now, here are the sentences. What's the matter with somebody? What's the trouble with somebody? What's wrong with somebody? Or what happened to somebody? Now, 大家可以看到 with 在这里起的作用。With 为介词，后跟人称代词的宾格，如 her, him, them. For example, these sentences. What's the matter with your mother? What's wrong with you? What's the trouble with her? 好，在这里呢，我们要注意一些小的细节。Matter, trouble, 前面呢加了字儿。而 what's wrong, 我们使用 wrong 来问的时候，前面是没有字儿的。而 happen, 大家注意到了没有？我们上个学期呢学过哈 ，happen 在使用的时候，我们的结构是 something happen to somebody. Are you clear now? Now, this is the first key point of the grammar focus. Now, let's look at the second key point in the grammar focus. In this part, we've learned how to talk about our health problems. For example, what's the matter with them? He has a stomachache. She has a toothache. He has a headache. He has a cold. She has a fever. He has a cough. She has a sore back. She has a sore throat. 好，大家可以看到，在所有的关于疾病的词组当中 ，have 扮演着很重要的一个角色。Now, let's watch a video about how we use have to express our health problems.
今天我们一起来学习 have 用于描述健康问题的用法。这节课的任务就是掌握它。我们都有过感冒的经历吧？看这位男士，他打了一个喷嚏。小男孩问他 Are you okay? 你还好吗？那么我感冒了用英语来怎么表达呢？ Have a cold. 是的， very good. 那么感冒严重了会引起发烧，那发烧用英语怎么说呢？看这组对话，医生问 What's the matter? 你怎么了？这位男士虚弱地说 I have a fever. 我发烧了。由此可见，发烧用英语说是 Have a fever.你有过肚子疼的经历吗？肚子疼你知道用英文怎么说吗？看这个捂着肚子的小男孩皱着眉头的医生说 I have a stomachache. 肚子疼是 I have a stomachache. 有些同学在活动的时候会不小心受伤，看这个孩子，他的胳膊受伤了，小伙伴关心地问 What happened? 他说 I had a broken arm. 我的胳膊受伤了。在这里 have 有受伤的意思，同学们在活动的时候一定要多加小心，不要再受伤哦。看了这么多的句子，大家想一想 have 在用于表达健康问题时是什么含义呢？对了，是患上遭受的意思。这些固定搭配同学们可要记住了哦。 Have a cold 感冒， Have a fever 发烧， Have a cough 咳嗽， Have the flu 得了流感。Have 在用于表达健康问题时，除了一些固定搭配，还有一些固定的结构。第一种 ，have a 加 ache， 比方说 have a stomachache， 肚子疼 ；have a toothache， 牙疼 ；have a headache， 头疼等等。Have 在用于表达健康问题时，还有 have a sore 加身体部位这样的句型。Sore 的意思是疼痛的，它是一个形容词。 不定冠词 a 根据后面的身体部位名词的单复数选择加与不加。例如 have a sore throat, 喉咙疼 have sore eyes, 眼睛疼 have a sore back, 后背疼。Have 在用于表达健康问题时也可以使用 have a pain in once 加身体部位的结构。比方说 have a pain in my knee, 膝盖疼 have a pain in my shoulder, 肩膀疼 have a pain in my toe, 脚趾疼。最后 have 在用于表达健康问题时还有受伤的含义。比方说 Steven has a broken arm, 史蒂夫的胳膊受伤了。
好，相信大家在观看了这个视频以后，对于 have 表达健康问题时候的用法应该是非常的清晰了。Now, let's come to the third point. Now, in Unit 1, Section A, we use should and shouldn't to give advice. Should 作为情态动词，表示应该、应当，常用来征求别人的意见或者是劝告。Now, for example, 这里的用法 should do something, 那我们知道 should 呢作为情态动词后面是跟动词的原型，也就是说没有人称和 should 的变化。For example, look at this picture. 我打精神病。Right, you should be quiet. And look at the second picture.我打精神病。Right. You shouldn't smoke here. Now, let's watch a video to learn more about how to give advice.
Hello, everyone. 今天我们来学习情态动词 should 表示建议的用法。Should 表示建议，意思是应该，比如，你应该做什么，你不应该做什么。我们来探究一下吧。同学们，马上就要放暑假了，你有什么安排吗？李明的妈妈给李明安排了暑假的作息时间，我们一起来看一看吧。You should get up at 7 o'clock. 李明的妈妈对李明说，你应该7点钟起床。那同学们猜一猜，李明要几点睡觉呢？ You should go to bed at 9 o'clock. 李明的妈妈要求李明，你应该9点睡觉，早睡早起身体好啊。除了规定了作息时间，李明的妈妈还对李明的暑假生活给出了建议。You should do your homework at home. 你应该在家里做作业。同学们，你们的妈妈是不是也总说这句话呀？李明的暑假生活还应该怎么做呢？ You shouldn't watch TV all the time. 你不应该总是看电视，所以李明要在暑假7点起床，9点睡觉，应该在家写作业，不应该总是看电视。同学们能做到这些吗？现在我们把刚刚学过的知识做个总结吧。Should 意为应该，表示劝告或建议，没有人称和 should 的变化，其后接动词原形。Should 的否定形式为 shouldn't 或者 should not, 意思是不应该。同学们，我们来做一个练习。试着翻译下面的句子，在春天，我们应该多和家人出去走走，不应该待在家里。答案应该是 In spring,We should go out with our family. We shouldn't stay at home. 怎么样？你做对了吗？除了用情态动词 should 表示建议外，同学们想一想，还有哪些表示建议的句型呢？大家一起来总结一下吧。How about 或者 what about 的意思是什么怎么样，后面加动名词。比如说 How about going swimming this afternoon? What about going swimming this afternoon? 我们下午去游泳怎么样呢？Let's do something. 这个句型大家应该非常熟悉了。它的意思是让我们一起做某事吧。Let's 后面加动词原形。Let's go to the park. 让我们一起去公园吧。Let's play basketball after school. 放学后让我们一起打篮球吧。下面我们来看看 why not 和 why don't you。这两个句型也是提建议的句型。意思是为什么不呢？ It's easy. Why not have a try? It's easy.Why don't you have a try? 太简单了，你为什么不试一试呢？同学们看出这两个句型的差别了吗？ Why not 后面直接接动词原形， Why don't 后面要先接主语再接动词原形，你记住了吗？除此之外， You'd better 也是表达建议的句型，意思是你最好做某事。但需要注意的是， You'd better 一般是长辈对晚辈的建议。 You'd better do your homework. 你最好现在写作业。You'd better not watch TV every day. 你最好不要每天都看电视。同学们看这个语气是不是比较强烈，甚至有一点点警告的意味呢？同学们，刚刚我们学习的内容掌握的怎么样啊？现在老师来考考大家。May I go out to play now? Sorry, dear, you 什么 finish your homework first. 小男孩问妈妈，我可以出去玩吗？妈妈说，不行，亲爱的，你应该先写完作业。所以答案是 C。接下来我们来看第二题。It's 3:15 a.m. You 什么 stay up too late? 现在已经是凌晨三点一刻了，你应该熬夜很晚还是不应该呢？很明显，不应该，所以选择 D。你选对了吗？
Now from this video, we know we can give advice in different ways. For example, now, look at this man. Maybe he has a headache. Now, let's give him advice in different ways. You should lie down and have a rest.You'd better lie down and have a rest. You can lie down and have a rest. Why not lie down and have a rest? And the last one, why don't you lie down and have a rest? 在这里呢，它分别用了 had better do something, can, why not, 为什么不呢？或者是Why don't you? 这四种形式，另外的四种形式也可以用来表达提出建议。Now, let's do an exercise. Now, please have a try. Now, have you finished? Let's see. Tom has a toothache.He should see a dentist. We can also say, he'd better go to the dentist. Why not go to the dentist? Now, from this part, we know we can use different ways to give advice. Number one, should do. Number two, had better do something. Number three,Can do. Number four, why not do something? Number five, why don't you do something? Number six and number seven, what about? How about? 好，在这里呢，我们要注意一个关注一个细节方面的问题。Should, had better, can, why not, why don't you? 后面在提出表示提出建议的时候，它都是用的是动词原形。而 what about, how about?因为 about 是介词，而我们知道介词后面动词是要加 ing 的。好，大家在运用不同的方式去提出建议的时候呢，要注意这个细节方面的东西。Now, boys and girls, please take out your books and finish 4A and 4B. Remember, practice makes perfect. 记住，熟能生巧。Now, let's first come to 4A. Fill in the blanks and practice the conversations. Number one, I hurt myself when I played basketball. 我打篮球时伤到了自己。Hurt oneself. 好，注意一下 oneself 通常是与主语保持一致，伤到了自己。那么这一主语是 I， 所以呢 I hurt myself。 OK， sometimes if I change I into he, we can say he hurt himself when he played basketball. Are you clear? What should I do?You should see a doctor and get an x-ray. 好，这里呢提出建议哈，你应该去看医生并且做个 X 光的检查。Number two, 第二个非常简单，对吧？ What's the matter? My sister and I have. 注意一下，这里是两个人，我们就不能用 has 了，而要用 have.My sister and I have sore throats. My sister and I have sore throats. 好，第二个空我们应该，第三个空我们应该怎么填呢？ Should we go to school? 把 should 提前作为一般疑问句。我们应该去学校吗？好，大家记得应该怎么回答？做否定回答。Right.No, you shouldn't. Now, number three. Does Mike have a fever? No, he doesn't. He has a stomachache. Okay, now, and A,gives advice. He should drink some hot tea. Did you do well? Okay, now let's come to 4B. Circle the best advice for these health problems. Then add your own advice. Pay attention. Then add your own advice.还要加进你自己的建议。选择好这里的建议，正确的建议以后，在横线上面再写出你自己的，你认为比较好的另外一条建议。Are you clear? Now, please do it. Go. Now, boys and girls, are you ready? Now, let's see the first problem. Jenny cut herself. Jenny 呢，切伤了自己。Cut oneself. Oneself 也是一样，与主语 oneself 与主语保持一致。Jenny cut herself. Jimmy is a boy. Jim cut himself.I cut myself. Okay, now let's see the right advice. Should she get an x-ray or put some medicine? Yes, she should put some medicine. Now, can you give your own advice?I think she should run it under the water, then put some medicine on the cut and bandage it, 然后再包扎。Now, number two. Kate has a toothache. Should she see a dentist or get some sleep? 她是应该看医生，看牙医，还是去多休息，多睡一会儿呢？那 which one is the right advice? The right advice is she should see a dentist. Now, can you give your own advice? I think she should get an X-ray. And number three, Mary and Sue have colds. They shouldn't sleep or exercise. Which is the right advice? Yes, they shouldn't exercise. Now, what's your advice? Yes, they should drink lots of water and have a good rest. Number four, Bob has a sore back. Should he lie down and rest or take his temperature? Now, what's the right advice? Yes, he should lie down and rest. Now, give him your advice. He shouldn't exercise. Now, boys and girls, do you feel tired? If you are tired, let's play a game. Now, let's come to 4C. Do a guessing game. One student minds a problem. 一个学生呢，扮演一个问题。For example, headache, toothache, or got hit by a ball. The other students in your group get the problem and give advice. 而其他的学生呢，就来猜这个问题，并且提出建议。Now, I have a problem here. I don't have any students here. What can I do? Don't worry. I drew a picture yesterday. Did I draw well? Oh, I heard somebody say, just so-so. It doesn't matter. Now, let me introduce my students to you. Student A. Student A is a student who minds a problem. 他是负责扮演问题的。Student B, C, and D. Student B, Student C, Student D. They are the other students who get the problem and give advice. 他们呢是负责猜问题并且给出建议的。Now, action. What's the matter? Did you hurt yourself when playing soccer? No, I didn't. Did you fall down? Yes, I did. You should go home and get some rest. So,I think this role play is very successful. Do you think so? Now, let's read the conversation together. What's the matter? Did you hurt yourself playing soccer? No, I didn't. Did you fall down? Yes, I did. You should go home and get some rest. Now,Do you know how to make such a conversation now? So, today's homework. Number one, imitate writing a conversation according to 4C. 那根据 4C 提供的例子呢，我们来仿写一段类似的对话。Number two, review 1A to 1D on page 6.预习一下第六页当中 1A 到 1D 部分的内容。Okay, boys and girls, that's all for our class. Goodbye, everyone.